about these mountain lions gagging up, man. And those are supposed to be solitary animals, man. Then the brother just showed me footage of a pack of dogs. I was like, is that in Chicago? I don't remember what he said. But I remember that in the early 90s, man. You could turn the corner and you could run into a whole pack of dogs, man. You know what I'm saying? Hey, you can still do that now. Hey, about 4 or 5 years ago, I turned the corner, it was a whole group of dogs, man. Like fucking 5 of them motherfuckers. Big motherfucking Rottweilers and shit, man. You know? Just roaming the street, running up on kids, kids screaming and shit, man. Oh, somebody give me that Teeth of Wild Beast, man. Or those Four Sword Judgments as well. Somebody get that, man. Because the Lord's, he's about to let these animals out the zoo. You gonna have some hippie like, no, they let the animals starve. Oh, we gotta go save him. He gonna be the first meal, by the way. That nigga gonna be the first thing that they eat when they leave, bro. They first free meal. Alright? But go ahead.
I got Sirach, man. It's Sirach 39 and 28. There be spirits that are created for vengeance, which in their fury lay on sore strokes. In a time of destruction they pour out their force and appease the wrath of him that made them.
Alright, read that again.
This is Sirach chapter 39 and verse 28. There be spirits that are created for vengeance, which in their fury lay on sore strokes. In a time of destruction, they pour out their force and appease the wrath of him that made them.
Right, man. So the Lord's about to be sending out, he's already sending out those death angels, man. Okay? And we seen one last year, man. Alright? That dark chariot that flew past. Right where those people was getting gunned down, man, down the street. Then dude went down to Everson and shot up some more motherfuckers, man. You know? You know, that was death angels. That was an all-black chariot. You know? Go ahead.
Verse 29, fire and hail and famine and death, all these were created for vengeance. Yep. Teeth of wild beasts and scorpions, serpents and a sword punishing the wicked to destruction.
Yeah. Lions and tigers and bears, oh my. My nigga. You, hey, listen, this is all the judgment of the Lord, man. Alright? Because wickedness has exceedingly polluted the earth, man. What scripture says, because they have imputed that because they have walked in great pride. They say like strange calamity. Yeah, the nigga woman's going down, man. Yeah. The nigga woman's going down. This, you know. Side note, go ahead.
The second Esdras chapter 8 and verse 50, for many great miseries shall be done to them that in a latter time shall dwell in the world because they have walked in great pride.
So all these miseries are coming upon these people because of great pride, man, because they won't turn back to their God. And it's about to turn up because we are in the year of the turn up. Okay? All right? We're in the year of the turn up, man. And y'all niggas is that frog who don't know it's getting hot. You don't know you're getting boiled. You know, you getting fried up. You ain't gonna jump out that pan, man. Alright? But hey, man, the Lord, because the scriptures talk about that pot. We go into it all the time. Ezekiel, that pot of scum. You know, this is that big melting pot of filth, man. You know? That cup that the woman had in the Revelations, that big cup full of abominations, man. The Lord's about to cook all this, man. Fire is the number one cleansing agent. Hey, the brother just read it. Fire shall often send out. Somebody give me that. What's the Bible? Unless you hold something already. Yeah, hold that. But somebody get that. What will I be?
What's that loop, right? Yeah. Devari, where's that at?
What will I for be already? Yeah, it's got
Kendall. It's Luke 20.
That's
Luke.
Luke.
Yeah, you got it right.
It's Luke
2:49.
It is Luke 12 and 49. I am come to send fire on the earth, and what would I if it be already kindled?
So this is the Lord speaking, man. This is the desire of who you call sweet Jesus. Okay? This is what he wants to do. Alright? This is the type of party he's about to throw, man. Alright? A death party. Leave your body at the door. Alright, it's what it says, the slain of the Lord shall be the slain of the Lord shall be many, man. Alright? Because the Lord is coming for vengeance. Alright? That's why Habakkuk said, and I wrath, remember mercy. You got something?
Yeah, I got a precept, brother. Yeah. This is Jeremiah chapter 16, verses 17 and 18. For mine eyes are upon all of their ways. They are not hid from my face, neither is their iniquities hid from mine eyes.
Right, because it says the eyes of the Lord are upon the sinful kingdom, man. Oh, it says his eyes go to and fro throughout the earth to show itself strong, man. You know? And who is the eyes of the Lord? Those angels, man, the chariots, man. Go ahead.
At first I will recompense their iniquity and their sin double, because they have defiled my land and they have filled mine inheritance with their carcasses of their detestable, abominable things.
Abominable things.
Yes, sir.
All right. Abominable, that's an exercise. Nah, but yo, abominable. But that's what they're doing right now, man.
You know it.
Yeah.
All
right. Right now, a lot of these niggas are throwing rocks, trying to throw rocks at the throne, man, of Yahweh Shai, man.
They
you
want
know?
Their preeminence?
Yeah.
They want their seat, man. See, that's a lot of these guys, they don't want to bow down to Yahweh Shai because they want their seat. They want to be the guy. Mm-hmm. When they're really not, man. Okay? Hey, Yahweh created Yahweh Shai, and you know, that's his number one creation, man. That's his, you know?
Jump back into the
Ezekiel 14 and verse 21. It says, for thus saith the Lord Yahweh, how much more when I send my four sword judgments upon Jerusalem.
And it's good to go over these things because the scripture says through fear we persuade men. Am I saying that?
The terror of the Lord, we persuade
men. Yeah, through the terror of Yahweh Shemi Shai, we persuade men, man. Alright? So if you had any fucking sense in your head, which really you just gotta be the elect, but you know, on the ground level, if you had any sense, you will fear, man. Okay? You know? Fear of Yahweh Shemi Shai is the beginning of wisdom, man. Right? You know? Go ahead.
It says the sword and the famine and a noisome beast and a pestilence. To cut off from it man and beast.
Cut off from it man and beast, man. So it's gonna be a lot of dead teens. A lot of dead teens, man. You know? Yo, a lot of you gonna get mauled by your household pets, man. If you don't eat them yourself. You know? It's gonna come to a point where your dog looking at you and you looking at him, and y'all like, man, one of us gotta go. You know what I'm saying? So this apartment is not big enough for the both of us.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So, hey, that's what it is. Or you kick him out, he's like, shit, I'll catch you outside. You got to come out sooner or later. Yeah, he done formed the whole gang. Now they waiting for you. These are the type of things that the Lord is bringing upon this earth, man. All right? And we're here to tell you about it. And warn you, you can get yourself right. Really? So we can get ourselves exonerated, so to speak. You know? The blood off our hands, man. You know? Because it says in this book, Ezekiel, I mean, it was like the 30th book, which says, give them warning for me. Yeah. So, hey, man, we can try to get that blood off our hands at the end of the day, man. You know? We taking our attitude of our Father, man. Is it gain to me that you are righteous? Look, we didn't gain nothing by you being righteous or you being wicked, man. Our gain is in doing this work and continuing therein. As Yahweh Shai said, I come to do the will of my Father and to finish the work, man. All right? So all this stuff we doing, it means nothing unless we pass that finish line, man. At the end of the day, we got to endure all the way to the end, man. You know, to the day that endure to the end, shall be saved. So we want to be hid from those said perils, like the scripture says, man. You know, we want to be hid in a day. What was it? If so, you may be hid in the day of the Lord's anger, or something like that. Yeah, man. We want to be hid in the day of the Lord's anger, man. You know, go ahead.
It says, verse 22. Yet behold, therein shall be left a remnant that shall be brought forth, both sons and daughters, behold, they shall come forth unto you, and ye shall see their way. I got the second
verse. You got the second verse now? What you got? Go ahead.
This is Zephaniah chapter 2 and verse 3. I start at verse 1. This Zephaniah 2 and 1. Gather yourselves together, yea, gather together, O nation not desired.
Right, and that's where we're gathered together, them that are sorrowful to the sorrow, that are mournful, to the solemn assembly, man. As the scripture says, man, this is the gathering of those that are mournful, man. Sorry for their sins, man.
Verse 2, before the decree bring forth, before the day pass as the chaff, before the fierce anger of Yahweh come upon you, before the day of the Lord's anger come upon you.
Man, get in. It's the name of Yahweh Bashmi Shai is a strong tower, man. The righteous runneth into it and is safe, man. So you better get in while you can get in. Otherwise, you can't get in. All right? And then you just can't leave. Go ahead.
Going back to it, this verse 3, it says, seek ye Yahweh, all ye meek of the earth, which have wrought his judgment, seek righteousness, seek meekness, it may be he shall be hid in the day of the Lord's anger.
It may be he be hid in the day of the Lord's anger, man. So you gotta take this thing serious, man. This is literally life or death. All right? You gotta take, this is a life or death situation. Oh, you got it, man.
This Psalms chapter 50 and verse 22, now consider this, ye that forget the Most High, lest I tear you in pieces, and there be none to deliver. Whoso offereth praise, glorify me, and to him that ordered his conversation aright will I show the salvation of God. Pray, man, hey, get it right. Hey, the Lord has extended his mercy unto you. Hey, walk how you ought to walk before the Lord come and bring that destruction and that punishment.
And that's why it says, extol not thyself and thy own counsel, unless ye be torn in pieces as a bull string alone, man. That's a Sirach, right?
Yeah, that's right.
And right now we're seeing a bunch of people extolling themselves in their own counsel. You know what I'm saying? Get that Bible be shot. Hold on, let's get this real quick. And then somebody get that definition of extol.
Hold it, I got you. This is Sirach chapter 6 and verse 2. Extol not thyself in the counsel of thine own heart, that thy soul be not torn in pieces as a bull string alone.
Now the brother just read how the Lord just said, lest I tear thee in pieces, man. All right? Is that the God they told you about in church? The one that'll tear you in pieces? Nah, I don't think you heard about that, man.
No, they just heard about the ones with the lollipops, cotton candy, ice cream sundaes.
Yeah.
You know,
that's
the one when they sing the song. He's coming back like I knew he would. Peace, blood, and happiness.
Nah.
He coming back with Brad.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
See, that guy, cheese and rice. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Cheese and rice ain't going. He ain't ripping nobody apart.
Nah.
He ripping up in a package to get you a candy bar.
Man, like Uriah always used to do. Like, he gonna come floating out. Love.
Yeah.
Love. Oh, love. Peace. Nah.
Right.
You got it. Hey, you got it wrong, what do you say? Juice. No, you got it wrong. You know what I'm saying?
That Riverside nigga.
Yeah. I heard Rodimus. You know what I'm saying? You got it wrong. Hey, y'all got it wrong, man. You know what I'm saying? These prosperity pastors, you know what I'm saying? They got it wrong, you know? Because they learned it from, you know, the seminary schools. You know what I'm saying? They about this world. See, the Lord, the true power, all right, ultimately, he's about another world, a world to come. Where he said that thy kingdom come, all right?
Yeah.
Where his inheritance is gonna rule.
Hey, the scriptures talk about, man, the Lord is gonna come. Yeah, listen, bro, the day of vengeance is in the Lord's All right. Somebody give me scripture that says, now will I raise up myself. Oh, you got that definition? But let me read this definition, though, because I wanted that.
This is the Webster's definition of the stole.
Yeah.
It says to praise highly.
Yeah.
Glorify.
Hey, and that's what people are doing right now, man. Men shall be lovers of themselves. Y'all been so fucked up, verse 3, fucking done. Scripture says that. Men shall be lovers of themselves, man. Okay? And we've seen a lot of guys come with their own opinion, man. Speaking against the prophets coming out right now, man. And the scripture says, lead not to thy own understanding, man.
Hey, that's that,
Yeah, bring it up.
Hey, in that Ezekiel 3 where it says that, thy people are stiff-necked and hard-hearted. I looked up that word hard-hearted. It goes into extremely stubborn, you know, extremely obstinate. And you go into obstinate, and it's leaning to basically die. Matter of fact, let me get it real quick since you said it.
Hard head, make a soft ass.
That's it. So it says, now this is what obstinate means, which goes into the word hard-hearted that explains the Israelites. It says obstinate, firmly or stubbornly adhering to one's own purpose, own opinions.
They don't understand.
Hey, it says not yielding readily to treatment.
hey, scripture talk about a mind well instructed, man. He refused instruction.
Yeah, yeah. Treatment. Yeah. Refuse treatment.
Yeah.
Hear this, nigga, you.
Fools
hey, I can fix that walk for you.
Yeah. No.
I'm good.
They got the truth antibody.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, they refuse the treatment and shit. They cussing you out for helping them.
Yeah.
Bitch ass nigga.
Yeah.
What the fuck? All
right. Right.
Bye.
You
know what I'm saying? They refuse to be healed, man.
Go ahead.
Let me get this piece of you. This is Proverbs 3:5. Trust in the Lord Yahweh with all thy heart, and lean not unto thy own understanding.
Right, man. Don't be hard-headed, man. Because the scripture says, is not my word like a fire, and as the hammer that break the rock in pieces?
Yeah.
See, we see these niggas, these hard-headed niggas coming out, because the word done hit them in the head and cracked their rock.
That's it.
And cracked their head, now they mad. You don't crack my damn head with the truth. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
Another one, because this is what's going
to
happen to
Can I say this real quick?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because I'm going to talk like, I got to talk like dudes with Batman. See, we adopted the truth. We've been molded by it. Right? Right? And they can say, I was molded by it. Right?
Oh,
that's
shit.
That's how we are, man. That's how the men of the Lord are.
Yeah.
They're not going to be an obstinate stone, man.
Right.
But they're going to get molded by the truth.
That's
See,
it.
When you hard-headed, the Lord can't do nothing with you. You're in that form. I can't do nothing but break you into power,
right,
man.
Hey, wait, stiff neck.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, but that's why it talks about how the Israelites are going to break these other nations, because these other nations, according to Sirach 33, they have their own ways that's innately in them. We're going to break them from that, and then we're going to teach them our ways, all right?
Yeah.
So right now, this is how our people are. They, you know, they just stubborn. They stiff neck, you know what I'm saying? They don't want to, basically, they can't be molded, you know what I'm saying? In the truth, like the brother was saying.
So you can't do nothing but break them.
This is Sirach chapter 5 and 2. Follow not thy own mind, and thy strength to walk in the ways of thy heart, and say not, who shall control me for my works?
Yeah, hey, I'm sorry, if I may say, because the scripture says, how the heart is desperately wicked, man.
Sir.
All right? The Hebrew word for heart is lav, which means your mind. So it says the mind is desperately wicked. Who could know it? All right? It's desperately wicked. That's why the Father, the scripture is saying, hey, man, lean not to your own understanding. Because your own understanding will have you in the ways of, you know, because the Lord said, my thoughts are not your thoughts. My ways are not your ways. See, the ways of the Father, like I always say, his nature is to live. All the Father do is live. He got the copyright on it, you know? And so here it is, our ways, if we're thinking according to our ways, which is a carnal way, to be carnally minded is death. All right, and so that's why he's saying, you know what? Rend your heart, rend your mind, all right, that produces death, all right, and come and follow my way. You got something? Okay, we're going to get back to that. Go ahead.
This is Sirach 5 and 3 now. I'm going to reread it. And say now, who shall control me for my works? For the Lord will surely revenge thy pride. You know, say the Lord, he's ultimately going to get you guys, man, who are prideful, all right? He's going to really show you who's the boss,
all right?
Simple as that.
All right, now.
You know?
Yep, go ahead, brother.
It's Proverbs chapter 14 and verse 12. There is a way which seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death.
You see? There's a way that seemeth right. Why? Because, well, it sounds good. You know, it's scientific. It's like, you know, that's what they said. You know, and it sounds good to me.
Right.
Yeah. Nah, but hey, yeah. The end thereof are the ways of death, man. We have to roll with in the spirit, man. And hey. The spirit is the power.
Hey, because Eliyahu Walker been talking about it. You got all these niggas mad about rap ass dying and shit, right? And then he's like, man, any minute he just come on YouTube, not show his face, like. They gave me an idea. I'm just gonna put a fucking channel with Zordon and shit.
Oh, I'm Zolotron Zulamax. I'm here to tell you the way of eternal creation.
Let's fucking just say a bunch of gibberish and people wanna hear that.
Right, right.
Why? Because they got itching ears, man.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
And the planet Nibiru.
Right.
And the aliens with the long penises.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They have the unboxing stand in
yes.
In Bakaru with
the Zolcats.
The Zolcats.
Well, for me, this nigga reading out of Dr. Seuss and shit. These motherfuckers.
The Zolcats.
Smoking blunts, believing this shit.
Right, right.
These are people, man. Sadist children, man.
And then the motherfucker. Come on, hey, man. With the blunt.
Zordon and shit.
Oh man. Hey, and you know, while in a sense it's funny, but for real, it's sad. Yeah, what you got, brother?
This is Matthew 12 and 27. It says, he is not the power of the dead, but the power of the living. He therefore do greatly err.
Yes,
you know, because the Lord, you know, like the brother said, man, Yahweh is about life, man.
That's right.
You know? That's why the scripture says that the spirit quickeneth us, man.
We were dead, man.
We were dead without the spirit of the Lord, man. Without that connection that we had with the Father, you know? So that's why at the end it says, ye therefore do greatly err, man. Because our people are in great error. Like they said previous, you know? That you guys got it wrong. Dead wrong. You know, because this is the truth of the Holy Scriptures. This is the truth of life itself. This is the truth of Yahweh Shai. Right, anything outside of this, it leads to death, man.
Right.
All right,
that's why you're not supposed to follow your own mind, man. Because hey, we've been bringing this out the past couple weeks. Man in his best state is all vanity. It's all vain. It's gonna lead to nothing but death.
Yep.
Whatever you believe in and feel, it's gonna lead to a death style. That's why you need the scriptures to filter everything out, so you know what's what's evil, what's good for you.
That's
all right.
Hey, what you got, brother?
I got a precept on that one. This is 1 Peter. 1 Peter 4th chapter 17th verse. For the time has come that judgment must begin at the house of Yahweh. And if it first begins at us, what shall the end be them that obey not the gospel of Yahweh?
Right, he that believeth not is condemned already.
Yes.
Alright, so hey, those that don't want to call on Yahweh Shai, all right, don't want to worship Yahweh Shai, you say kiss the son, at least he'd be angry. And you perish.
This Ezekiel chapter 33 and verse 11, saying to them, as I live, saith Yahweh power, I have no pleasure in the death of the wicked, but that the wicked turn from his way and live. Turn ye from the evil, from your evil ways, for why will you die, O house of Israel?
I'm sorry about to mention something. You righteous that turn into wickedness, all right? If they don't receive the warning and turn back, man, they're going to get judged anyway. At the end of the day, man, the Lord is warning the elect, man. This is really for the elect of Israel, all right? That's why the message is constantly to the meek, to the watchmen, to those that seek the righteousness of Yahweh Shammah Shai, because ultimately, the Lord has his eyes and his heart really fixated on the elect, man.
That's it.
All right?
forget. Nope. It says the rest was born in vain. Why? Because they didn't want to go according to the plan of the Most High to be purified and perfected. Rolling with the Most High's righteousness, man. That's why it says, hey, the brother brought it out earlier how, hey, there's a way that seemeth right unto a man. All right, but the end thereof are the ways of death. All right, because people are going about to establish their own righteousness and have not submitted to the righteousness of God. See, the righteousness of God is what produces life eternal. All right, and this is what we're talking about back here. All right, and that's what we're rehearsing back here to the best of our ability, man. All right, and have that mindset. All right, not lean into our own understanding and have wanting our own will to be done. Not going about to establish our own righteousness. Nah, we going according to what thus saith the Lord, man. All right, through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shem Yahshua, because that's an ability, all right, to have faith in the truth and apply it to the best of your ability. That's a gift, all right, from the Most High God, man. You know, you got something?
Yes, sir.
What you got, brother?
This is Isaiah 21, and I started 8. And he cried and lying. My Lord, I stand continually upon the watchtower in the daytime, and I am set in my word whole night. And behold, here cometh a chariot of men with a couple of horses. And he answered and said, Babylon is fallen, it is fallen, and all the great images of her God have broken onto the ground.
Yep, because here it is, the Most High is a righteous God, man. He's not going to have this present evil world continuing on where he gave over unto man and man's ways and man's devices to lean upon their own understanding to enact their way. He gave the earth into man for a time and for a purpose, all right? And then ultimately in the kingdom of heaven, now it's going to be like, now you see, this is rolling with my way. This is being smart. This is being wise where you would roll with the power. And not just any power, the highest power.
Right.
All right? The highest power. So, because it's wise to roll with the power. But when you say that, well, they'll be like, well, this guy, he's in power right now. And they'll be pointing to the Edomite. You know what I'm saying? But they don't understand. Huh? Right. Exactly. See, but they ain't looking at the power above them. Hey, what you say, Ioana? They be higher than they. You know what I'm saying? So the highest is the Most High God, man, Yahweh. And you want to roll with his way. All right? You want to roll with his way. You got something?
It kind of reminds me of the scene in the movie 300 when Artaxerxes was telling, what was the other guy's name? Leonidas. He was telling him, he was like, you say, you see that I'm a Christian God. You just need it. And we will see that Yahweh Yahusha is good to them. They humble themselves before him, man.
Yeah.
Because if not, hey, you're going to be broken into pieces, man.
That's it.
You say, my people shall be willing in the day of my power.
Yeah. And we have to humble ourselves and know that, hey, yo, we ain't got it. It's the Most High that got it. You know what I'm saying? And those that humble themselves to that, all right, humble themselves to the power, again, being, it says the beginning of wisdom is the fear of the Most High God. Knowing that, you know what, if you don't roll with the Most High God and his ways, there's a consequence. And the consequence ain't fun. It ain't nice. It ain't pretty. It don't feel good. So if you want to roll, you know, with power and be healthy and have life eternal, then you will want to roll with what the Most High God say. His righteousness, what he say morality is, what he say do and don't do.
That's why it says in Proverbs, it says, then you says you are born at the last, when our flesh and that body is consumed.
You see?
And you'll say, how did I not listen to my teaching?
Right. How was I was a dumbass. Because here it is, you know, wisdom again is to fear the Lord and to obey what he say and roll with what he say, because he the power. Yeah.
It's Isaiah chapter 45 and 18. For thus saith Yahweh that created the heavens, The Most High himself that formed the earth and made it, he have established it. He created it not in vain. He formed it to be inhabited. I am Yahweh, and there is none else. I have not spoken in secret. In a dark place of the earth, I said not unto the seed of Jacob, seek ye me in vain. I, Yahweh, speak righteousness. I declare things that are right.
I declare things that are right. Yeah, ain't no wrong.
Right.
All right, everything that he do, even though you may perceive that he messed up or he did wrong, sure. All right, but then that's your dumb ass.
Hey, are not my ways equal?
Exactly. Are not your ways unequal? Yeah. All right, he said, what was that last thing he said, man?
He said, I, Yahweh, speak righteousness.
I, Yahweh, speak righteousness.
I declare things that are right.
Go back to that.
I got a precept.
Hey,
hold on. You know, it says, let God be truth, and every man a liar. If you rolling with your own way, your own will, you establishing your own righteousness, you a liar. Because that ain't righteousness.
I got two.
The Most High God got the copyright on righteousness. You can't tell him what's righteous. He tell you. The Most High made you, fool.
One
path. Meticulous. You know what I'm saying? Because a little smidge of you, you know, going not according to life.
Yeah. You got different kinds of death. You got slow death. You got fast death. You got wet death. You got dry death.
Wait, you're like Bubble. You're like shrimp scam.
Yeah. You got gumbo death.
Gumbo death. Suicide death. Death sandwich. Death tartar. You know what I'm saying?
It's all death.
You're right. You know? Right, that's why it says, hey, 6 million ways to die. Choose one. It says there's a many go into the broad way that leadeth to destruction, man. Right? But there's only one way to life, man. That's why I say a little leaven. Leaven is the whole lump, man. A little corruption. Oh, the whole damn thing is corrupt, man. Because now it's not pure. Go ahead.
This is Ezekiel chapter 33 and verse 11. Saying to them, as I live, saith Yahweh power, I have no pleasure in the death of the wicked, but that the wicked turn from his way and live. Turn ye from your evil ways, for why will ye die, O house of Israel?
Why will you die, dude? And it says, because of your iniquities, good things have been withheld from you. Life is a good thing.
Exactly.
And it says, any day above ground is a good day. Well, see. Okay. We about to see about that. This is Jeremiah 8:3. And death shall be chosen rather than life by all the residue of them that remain of this evil family which remain in all the places where I have driven them, saith Yahweh Pavos.
Well, I was going to say, it says death shall be chosen rather than life. Why? Because they have what's the word I'm looking for? They think that it's freedom.
Yeah.
They think that it's liberty.
Yeah.
Right, an illusion. Right? Illusion of liberty. Illusion of freedom. Yeah. Alright? But ultimately, it's just death.
Yeah. They're pining away. The scripture says, you shall pine away in a strange land and the iniquities of your fathers, you shall pine away. Just like Daniel told those two men.
Judith.
Yeah. Okay? He said, thou that art waxing old in thy wickedness, man. You niggas been old and wicked for a long ass time, man. You think all this rapping, this hip hop was just the beginning of this wicked nasty shit? Nah, you had me and Mrs. Jones.
Right.
Shit, you go back to the fucking, you got some bitch singing about her coochie.
Right,
in the fucking
20s. 30s,
and shit, man.
Suzanne Doctor had all those. Suzanne had that Levi with the, what was it? It was concubine?
Yeah, yeah, the juke joint.
No, she went to play hard and got gangbanged, that literally.
Yeah. Niggas been wicked for a long fucking time, man. Well, it says that in Second Evidence. It talks about how much wickedness have that seed and how much more. Man, go ahead and bring it out, man.
I got it. This is Second Evidence chapter 4 in 30. For the grain of evil seed has been sown in the heart of Adam from the beginning. And how much more ungodliness hath it brought up unto this time?
All the way to this day. To this day. Go ahead.
And how much shall it yet bring forth until the time of the threshing?
So how much more? Last year we had Desmond is amazing. This year we gonna this year we just gonna have fucking strip. Shit, we might have strip clubs. Only clubs are open are fucking for kids. Because they don't get the Rona like you grown up, so they can go in there and shake their ass. Now you can go on Netflix and watch fucking 11-year-old girls shake their ass. Okay? Alright? Now you got mothers marrying their daughters and fathers taking baths with their sons.
Oh, yeah, shit. You see that thing I posted? Yeah. You got these two guys right there. You know, they're grown.
Yeah.
But the one's a dad who's about, like, probably, like, you know, 60 or something. And you got the son that's, like, 30. They're our OnlyFans taking new photos together in bathtubs and shit. This is what's going on in the world, bro.
Yeah, man.
Hey, that's why the scriptures talk about that wickedness has exceedingly polluted the earth. If a brother could get that, I think Second Ezra 15.
Yeah, they hurtful works of a fear. Somebody get that Second Ezra
15.
Hey, also how the scriptures talk about, if the Lord, you know, basically didn't shorten the time, there would be no flesh left to be saved, roughly paraphrasing, man. All right, because like the brother brought out, man, that evil that was sown in the beginning, all right, all it's doing is producing, all right, evil. Evil seed, all it can produce is evil, all right? And guess what? Every second of every minute of every hour of every day of every week, all right, so on and so forth, guess what? Wickedness grows. It continues to grow. So if you are about this place, then you are about wickedness. See, we back here, we want the Lord to hasten that day to come and uproot the wickedness and plant the kingdom of heaven, which is that righteous seed.
Hey, you ever seen one of those scary looking ass trees? It's like, it don't even got that many leaves on it. It's still alive, but it's got like a little bit of fucking leaves on it. And it just don't look like none of the other trees that's around the area. It's all, it just look like it's come alive and shit. Like, nigga, why is this shit here? Like, this is some fucking Freddy Krueger type shit, man.
That's why they use shit like that, like Halloween
and shit. It look like it's gonna start talking and shit.
Right.
Yeah, man, that nigga gotta go, man.
Put that tree down, man.
Yep.
Ain't no fruit coming from it anyway. It got three leaves, and it proves the fact.
Exactly.
And it's the only way. It's the only way to establish the good tree is to take that bad tree out from the root, man.
Yeah.
You know, so it don't get contaminated, so it don't get corrupt, man.
Hey, the other trees is all downwind, looking at that tree like this and shit, like, we're not going to grow over there. You know what I'm saying? That nigga's occupying a big-ass space and shit
like nutrient thieves over there.
But that's how Esau is. The scripture says, warning him to join house to house, that he may be left alone, man. Yeah, all right? He'll tell you that you're overpopulated, then push your ass into a little-ass area, a million of y'all ass, which big cities like this, millions of y'all ass pushed in one area, here he got all this land, and it could be farmed. You would think it's farmland, but it's just fucking nothing.
It's golf clubs. You go out to the outskirts of the city right now, man, all right? And they got acres, man, of different kind of clubs, man. That's why they show that so much in those movies. When they got Esau with the Docker Zone, you know what I'm saying? Hopping into his red BMW convertible. All right, he takes his motherfucking ride to the damn country club, man.
Or it's just brown grass and tumbleweeds, man. For fucking 100 miles, man. Brown ass grass and tumbleweeds, man. And fucking dead deers on the highway.
Man, this is not the highway. Yeah.
And
that's how his kingdom would look. That's how the devil's kingdom would look, man. Bunch of dead things.
I got second entrance 15:6. It says, "For wickedness hath exceedingly polluted the whole earth."
That's right. And that's why this place needs to get cleansed, man. Because it's polluted, man. First off, spiritually, you know, mentally, and then physically, man.
Every leap.
Come on, man.
Bruce Lee, whole family.
Right.
Uncle Lee.
Right.
Auntie Lee. Right.
Every lead, man.
You know? And I got a precept real quick. This is Genesis 6:5. It says, "And the Most High saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually."
See? You're only evil continually, man. Because, you know, they just want to go according to their flesh, man. Right? Going according to their flesh. But that produces death all the time.
But I can feel good for that moment. Feels good for those few seconds.
Exactly. You know? See, you know, that's what it's about. It's chasing that high. Chasing that pleasure. You got something?
They're all junkies, man. That's literally what they are, man.
Exactly.
They're all junkies. A junkie, man, they know what they're doing is going to kill them at the end of the day.
Yep.
But, man, they get high, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They get hours real quick.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Even though the arm's about to fall off, they're like, fuck it, put another needle.
Yep. That's it. What you got, bro?
This is Revelation's 2:9. "I know thy works, and tribulation, and poverty, but thou art rich. I know the blasphemy of them which say they are the Jews, and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan."
And those are the ones right now that's pushing them. See, we can use that now for the Amalekites, all right? So-called Ishes, okay? That is in power right now, and they're the ones that's pushing their vibration, all right? And it says that they were going to roll upon their belly and go upon their appetites, man. They're totally about the flesh, man. Totally contrary to the spirit. All right? So if they're totally contrary to the spirit, all right, then they're totally contrary to righteousness.
Yes, sir.
All right? So they're all about wickedness. And that's what they push, okay? But the thing is, they don't just come out and say, yes, we're pushing wickedness. No, they're going to say it like it's a good thing, like it's righteous. All right? They're going to cover it up. They're going to be deceitful. They're going to be like that serpent, that sly fox. They're cunning. They're subtle. All right? They're deceiving. So here it is. They have you, whether directly or indirectly, all right, involved in wickedness, man. Nigger them.
hey, man, we are in no way, shape, or form
involved in any nigga.
So at the end of the day, man, it's you niggas, man. Because we're really on the subject of you niggas right now. We get on Esau in a minute. Right now, we're talking about you niggas. Okay? Alright? You niggery ass niggas.
Yeah.
Alright? Especially now, because the hot thing that's going on right now. There's all these scorners that's coming out of the woodworks because of a wicked nigga that fucking died that the Lord put to death, man. All right? And rightly so, man. Because he was speaking blasphemies, man. All right? We're speaking life over here, man. We're speaking things to get you saved. This nigga was telling you that you cannot be saved. Why would you even? It boggles my mind how he had so many supporters. But you know what? Now it doesn't, because what we're going into right now is they love death.
Yeah.
Oh, they didn't. Somebody get that. They didn't take hold of his side. You find it? Hold what you got out.
All right.
Okay? Let me get that, though. They didn't take hold of his side. Do find death, man. Y'all love death. Here it is. You got a guy telling you ain't got no redemption for sins. You ain't got no mediator. You got no way back to the Father. There's a planet behind the sun that's going to eat you. But y'all mad at us because we telling y'all if y'all walk mournfully before the Lord, he'll forgive you and you can live forever. What kind of sense does that make, man? You know? And I can try to stay on subject, you know, when you bring out scripture. You know? Go ahead. Wisdom of Solomon.
It's Wisdom of Solomon chapter 2:24. "Nevertheless, through envy of the devil came death into the world, and they that do hold on his side do find it."
Right, through envy of the devil came death into the world, man. Why? Because the scripture says,
way, chiefly that was committed to them was the Word of the Most High God. All right, this Word of God, man, this is to the Israelites, man. All right, it's the Israelites that has the promise of these laws, statutes, and commandments and His wisdom being put inside you to where He's going to cause you, all right, to walk in His ways, and His ways is immortal. All right, go ahead.
This Wisdom of Solomon 2 and verse 23. For the Most High created man to be immortal and made him to be an image of his own eternity. Nevertheless, through envy of the devil came death into the world, and they that behold on his side do find
him. What's that stupid say? They pulled death upon them? Anybody know that? What it says, they pulled death upon them?
Somebody see what that said. They pulled death upon them.
I think we got Ecclesiasticus chapter 47, verse 25. For they sought out all of the wickedness till this vengeance came upon them.
Oh, that's a good one. What was that?
That was Ecclesiasticus.
What about wisdom?
Just say Sirach.
Yes, sir.
Wisdom of Solomon right. 1 and 12. Yeah. Seek not death in the era of your life, right, and pull not upon yourselves destruction with the works of your hand.
Why will ye die, man? Okay? You know? Here it is, you got a motherfucker like, I want to try crack today. Why would you die? Nigga, it don't say crack has vitamins. This is fortified with all the vitamins and minerals that you need for a balanced sex.
Right, it never says
that about crack. Too much of this shit, you'll fucking die. Keep out of reach of the children. All right? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. All right?
So, they are to be following along, and they'll still stick the needle, man. You know, like, you'll tell Jake, hey, man, that's wrong, it's bad, this and that. You know what I'm saying? You give them some counsel. You try to show the love through the correction, and Jake,
Let's bring this out, Bobby.
Can I bring out this definition? It's stubborn, but it says an adjective. It says having or showing dogged determination not to change one's attitude or position on something, especially in spite of good arguments or reasons to do so. And that's all.
In spite of good reasoning, man.
Right.
That was what it says. Their ears are dull of hearing, man. You know? Hey, that's just a shit sandwich. What? Nigga still chewing this shit.
Still, man. Still.
What is he talking about? That's some mustard, nigga.
Go ahead.
It's Jeremiah chapter 8 and verse 3. And death shall be chosen rather than life, but all the residue of them that remains in this evil family, which remain in all the places where I have driven them, saith Yahweh of hosts. So, hey, our people, they ultimately choose ways that's going to lead to death, man, rather than life. And then you go and reprove them, you tell them, like, look, man, what you're doing is going to fuck you up. They say, I ain't trying to hit none of that. I'm going to steal dude.
Right. You saw them like a big-ass Mediterranean meal and shit. You got fucking hummus. You got the fucking chicken seasoned
Jerusalem
curry.
Salad.
Yeah, ooh, Jerusalem salad. Ooh. You show them that fucking chopped up cilantro. You got the motherfucking grass fed lamb. All right? You know what I'm saying? Baked to perfection and shit.
No, I'm gonna take a McDouble.
No, yeah.
That looks good and all, but McDouble.
Man, this ain't no checkers.
You in a supersized. This you niggas, man. Oh, you got a big ass feast, right? Hey, you got a big ass feast. You can't see the end of the table. Right? You got a brother standing there with a big ass beard, crown, and shit. Ha ha! Feast! Yes! Nigga, where's the crack? Nigga. Is there any crack here?
y'all got the ribs on deck?
It's women serving.
Ribs and crack.
What a crack.
Yeah, with that Taco Bell chicken wing.
Taco Bell chicken wing. Where that at?
I can't eat without a black in my
mouth. Go ahead. That's our people, boy.
This is the book of Acts, chapter 7, verse 51. It says, ye stiff-necked and uncircumcised in heart and ears.
Right. Uncircumcised in heart. All right, what's the Hebrew word for heart? Lav, which means your mind. Uncircumcised in your mind.
So you got all type of stuff that produces, you know, bacteria, produces disease, produces infection, all right? And that you just got all that stuff, and you ain't purged it. You ain't got rid of it. You uncircumcised in heart and ears. Your ears is full of, you want to hear stuff that produces death. All right, stuff that's not needed. Nah, you gotta cut that off. All right, we gotta purge that, man. All right, and roll with the way Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. But again, it says that men love darkness rather than light, man, because their deeds are evil, and they love to do those evil deeds because those deeds are pleasurable.
Yes.
Just for the heck of it, I got the definition of uncircumcised.
Go ahead, brother.
A perimetos. It says those whose heart and ears are covered. In example, whose soul and senses are closed to divine admonition.
Woo! Damn. Closed to divine admonition. Divine warning. Yes. It said, hey, it is high time to awake out of sleep, for your salvation is nearer than you believe. Yep. All right? And so since your salvation is nearer than you believe, guess what? Also, the destruction of this place is nearer than you believe. And since the destruction of this place is nearer than you believe, the scripture says, what manner of persons ought ye to be in holy conversation and godliness? And you have to be in holy conversation and godliness, all right, wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, and have that faith in it and applying it to the best of your ability, because that is the strength of your salvation. Alright, that's the stability of your times, man. Alright, so, but if your mind is clouded by the philosophies and ways of this world, the American dreams, and you know, all the stuff of this world, then guess what? Then your mind, your ears is blocked, man, from hearing the divine admonition, man. To saying, hey, the Lord is coming back with this fire, and then people not fearing. See, you're going to learn the fear. That's why it's a bunch of dumbasses out here, because they're not fearing. See, the beginning of wisdom is the fear of the Lord.
Right.
All right, to know that, wait a minute, if I'm not going according to what he say righteousness is, then, and if I'm not rehearsing that to the best of my ability, then I get caught up in this, you know, fire that he's coming back with. I have a fucking idea with it. Hey, wait, I'm going to be in the kingdom anyway. Remember, people used to say that.
Yeah, yeah,
you know
yeah,
what
yeah.
I'm saying? Oh, well, shit, I'm being the kingdom anyway. I might as well have my fun right now, too. You know what I'm saying? You see, that's a dumbass foot. All right? Because they don't fear what the Lord could do and what the Lord is going to do.
We always bring that out about the second of the 9 chapter. It says, dwell in torment.
Dwell in torment. Uh-huh. See, but when your mind is blocked, you don't get that admonition. Uh-huh. You don't get that form. Because your mind is blocked with all the things of this world and partying, having fun, and being in pleasure, and not going through the straight gate, man.
What time does the dispensary close?
This is Psalms 10:4, and it reads, the wicked through their pride of his countenance, through the pride of his countenance, like him, will not seek after God. God is not in all his thoughts. I read that one more time.
Yes.
The wicked, through the pride of his countenance. Through pride of his countenance.
Uh-huh.
And what the scripture says about pride, seek out it says God.
One depart from his maker.
One depart from his maker. You know?
Yep. So that's what pride produces. Go ahead.
Yeah, through the pride of his countenance will not seek after God. God is not in all his thoughts.
See, the Most High is not in all. See, when we're going about our day, all right, and every step that we make, we want to make sure that, all right, this is cool with the Most High. I'm within righteousness. I'm within the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High God. You know? Those frontlets, man. All right? And you filter everything through what the scriptures say. All right? And that's why it says, then wisdom shall meet you in every thought.
Yes, sir.
All right? If you about the discipline, all right?
and being disciplined, all right, and being nourished and disciplined, all right, the ways of the Most High God, man. So it should be in all your thoughts. See, but with the wicked, not so. They going according to whatever it is they flesh want to do.
They don't have any proof, all right? They have no prudence in human foresight. Never goes if they have it with them. Because if you have prudence, you would think about your actions and you'd be like, well, if I did this, what are the possible outcomes?
That's it.
All right? You know, we know that maybe ABC, you know, happens on XYZ, you know? See, these people, they play, and that's how chess players, you know, they think about all these different moves before they actually make that one particular move.
Right. And one move, you may have got the pawn.
Yeah.
And so that's a good thing. You got a pawn, right?
Yep.
But you didn't look at the move that, well, if I all I got was a pawn, but now he got my knight and my rook or something. You know what I'm saying? Yep. So you looked at, oh, okay, this is a good thing because, all right, this is pleasurable right now. Yeah. But you ain't looking at the after that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You got to look at the ultimate, all right, what's going to happen. Not just, all right, well, this pleasurable to me now. You know what I'm saying? This pleasurable to me now. But then, what about after? Here it is. It's like that day, I was eating that ice cream. That's a good move I made, eat this ice cream. Mm-hmm. It's good. Real good. I'm enjoying this. This is pleasurable. A couple hours later, on the toilet. Oh, fuck. Right. So here it is. We didn't think about the ultimate, man. You know? And that's the thing. That's that foresight. That's that prudence that we have to have, man. And rolling with the ways of Yahweh Shalom Shai. Because if you're rolling with your own ways again, then your mind is cloudy. Your mind is blocked. Go ahead and finish that.
Proverbs 10. 4 and 5, the wicked through the pride of his countenance will not seek after God. God is not in all his thoughts. His ways are always grievous.
See, his ways are always grievous. Go ahead.
Thy judgments are far above out of his sight. As for all his enemies, he puffeth at them.
You know, that's mainly going to Esau, but it's still, you got, what you say about our people, they are like their father's devils. Alright, they bow out to the ways of Esau. And Esau is what? The most prideful, you know, individual out there, man. Okay? And when, if you follow the ways of Esau, man, you want death, man.
That's it.
Okay,
seek the Lord, power, and their fathers with all their heart, with all their soul, that whosoever would not seek the Lord, God of Israel, should be put to death, whether small or great, whether man or woman.
And it's just that simple.
Put to death by following the way of the Most High God.
Because ultimately, you know, they like the brother was going into, a slow death, fast death, death sounded, death scampy, you know what I'm saying? No matter how it is, which it is, slow, fast, whatever, you know what I'm saying? You're born according to your own ways, the ways of man, man. That's what that produces, man. All right? Go ahead.
That's that club of land breakdown. What is your prediction?
Hey!
Baby. I got a precept.
Yeah.
Lock 3.
This is Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 2. Yeah, I'll start at 23, verse 1 to 24. This is Wisdom of Solomon 2 and 23. For the Most High Yahweh created man to be immortal and made him to be an image of his own eternity. So really, we are designed to be immortal, but we know that what? Adam, you know, he ate those fruit of lives, okay? And then, you know, hey, that death came in, okay? So, verse 24, nevertheless, through envy of the devil came death into the world, and they that do hold of his side do find it.
That's it, because that's what that produces, man. Any way outside of the way of righteousness. outside of the way of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. Alright? It produces death. That's what it produces, man. Alright, and sure, you may have fun for a little while. You may have a little pleasure here and there. But it's really, man, it's bullshit because here it is, that pleasure, it goes down. That high goes down, and that's all you're searching for. You know what I'm saying? Exactly. Because that's what you always, you know, you're looking for, man. All right, you're never satisfied, man. That's the flesh. That's death. Death is insatiable, man. Always want more.
This is Psalms 19:7. The law of Yahweh is perfect, converting the soul. The testimony of Yahweh is sure, making wise the simple.
Right, and it ultimately leads to you being perfected, man. That's good. It ultimately leads to you being perfected, man.
Yep.
You know?
Yeah. It says, the statutes of Yahweh are right, rejoicing the heart. The commandment of Yahweh is pure, enlightening the eyes.
Right, the eyes, so you can see what's going on, man. So you can see what's ahead, man. So you can know your duty on this earth as an Israelite, man. All right, which is this is the whole duty of man. What does Yahweh Shema Shai require of thee?
Yeah.
To walk mournfully with thy power?
Right. Okay. Yeah. See, because right now the world was given over into the hand of the wicked.
Right.
And it says, when the wicked are in authority, the people mourn, man. Alright? So this is a time of mourning because the wicked is in authority, and wickedness is the vibration of this present evil world. Alright? And in the present evil world, we shouldn't be in a mind state of party and having fun and like, oh yeah, we this is it.
Yeah.
No. In a place of wickedness, we like, damn, you know what I'm saying? In a place of wickedness, unrighteousness, weakness, infirmities, you know what I'm saying? That's where we like, man, we signed it crying. Alright? We're mad. Alright? We're angry. We're upset. Alright? We're wanting the Lord to hasten that day for the place where righteousness is prevalent. Righteousness is the order of the day. Alright? That's the place where we're trying to get to. But all the while we are here, because we're here for a purpose, all right, and it's to fight against wickedness, it's to renounce the wickedness. We had to touch it, to know it, but then once we touched it, we got defiled therewith. So now we have to go through the fire to purge, all right? And you have to accept that fire. You have to accept that furnace of adversity, all right, to be purified. Because if you don't accept it, then that means you born in vain. Alright, because that's the purpose right now.
Yep.
That's how we were going to be perfected. Alright, because we were already made to be the righteous. But to go on to perfection, we had to know wickedness too. We had to know the balance and the all sides. To know it, we had to experience it. Alright, once we experience wickedness, then that means that, oh well shit, we got defiled with it. Alright, so now we have to be cleansed from it. The only thing that's going to cleanse us is the word, having faith in it, and applying it to the best of our ability. That's what's going to cleanse us. That's up.
Yeah. Now, back up, it says, the bride of the wicked shall not rest upon the body of the righteous, unless the righteous put forth his hand to iniquity.
That's it.
All right? So, hey, man, once you put your hand towards, put your hand forth to iniquity, then you receive death. As it says, he that to whom ye yield your members, ye are a servant of. So if you yield your members unto the works of death,
yeah. You
are a servant of death.
That's it.
Yeah.
That's it. Go ahead.
This is Ecclesiastes. Ecclesiastes 3.
Hey, I just had to tell my girl, man. I'm like, man, you know, see, these people, especially these women, they talk about not being controlled by the man. Right? All you want to do is control. Well, sure. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm the power. You know what I'm saying? There's an order. Just like
Yahawashai wasn't willy-nilly doing whatever he wanted to do. He was under the control of the power, which was his father, Yahweh. All right? And then he's the dominant. Yahawashai is the dominant over us. Yahawashai should be in control over us. All right? Because we are the weaker to Yahawashai. You know what I'm saying? And so he should, hey, we should love for him to have the control over us. All right? And just like we should have control over the weaker vessel, over the woman. Just like also, you know, we should have control over our flesh. It says that the flesh is weak. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. So it's not our flesh that should have control over our spirit, but it's our spirit that should have control over our flesh. Because if our flesh had control over our spirit, then the flesh win, the carnality win, death win.
Right, you don't let your car drive you, man. Right?
Right.
I'm just gonna let the car go.
Whatever it do.
But that's what Michael, that's what the backwards man wants.
Yeah.
He saw.
Yeah.
Michael, we're going over a cliff.
Whatever.
Right.
Michael, I'm gonna drive to the crack spot. You ready?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Wherever you take me.
Yeah. They just robbed the bank. Michael, let's help them get away.
Right.
Right, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Nah, you don't do that, man.
No, you gotta control the weaker, man.
Yeah.
All right, that's what it's all about, man. And this is what we're learning. And so it says that the flesh. All right, it says, the Apostle Paul said, in my flesh dwelleth no good thing. So if I'm going to let no good thing control me, then I'm going to be into nothing. Well, I'm going to be a no gooder. You know what I'm saying?
No good food.
Right. Right.
A doer of no good.
That's it.
Hey, everybody see that? No, he's not going to do nothing good.
That's it.
You know what I'm saying? The old lady that needed help across the street.
That's why it talks about a child that is left to himself. You know what I'm saying? Becometh willful, man. And that's Esau. He's just a child in the earth, man. With no discipline. Doing whatever the fuck. That's why this place has become a hell. When it was made to be a paradise. In the beginning, it was a paradise. Alright? See, but the little child, Esau, with no discipline, that's totally carnal. All right, the Most High is not at all his fault. And so, since that's the case, he doing all whatever. Oh, shit, touch, taste, feel, sight. Yum, yum. Give me this, give me that. I want this, I want that. Heap it to him. All nations, all people, all lands, all this. Want all of this. I want control of this, or that, or that.
I want it all.
Right. And I want it now. All right? And have no discipline. Have no control.
No patience.
No patience. Now.
Right. That's why everything here is bought, sold, manufactured. What do you call it? Now they trying to sell you robot quick. Fuck, why waiting for me? You tired of waiting for bitches not to call you back? Are you tired of hoes coming to the bar and drinking up their drinks and not giving me no pussy? Well, I got some robot. I have a robot vagina. Bitches coming to your home. I'm going to give you a hand.
Right, you know what I'm saying? Disclaimer, you know, man ordering food.
Yeah. You know? Hey, that's because we're dealing with a microwave mentality.
Yeah.
Because we're dealing with an impatient motherfucker.
That's it.
He couldn't even wait for his brother to finish cooking the lentils with the vegan.
Yeah. Hey, the Most High said how he waited for the precious fruit of the earth, all right, and have what?
Long patience for
it, all right?
Long suffering.
That's it. All right, that's because it's a process, man. All right, to be perfect, man, that's a process, all right? And we have to roll with the process, and that's why he's saying all the time, man, wait ye upon me, and your patience. Possess ye your soul.
He said, I shall sit as a refiner of silver.
See?
That takes time.
That's it.
That's watching.
Yep.
That's patient.
That's it, man.
He said he can't take his eye off of silver. Okay? He take his eye off of it, he gonna fuck it up.
Yeah.
It's gonna be overcooked. You know? Or undercooked. You know?
Yep. That's it, man. Alright? We're being perfected here, man. No,
and while we're being perfected, you know, we're going through that change. And when you're going through change, you know what I'm saying, sometimes that, you know, it don't feel good. Just like when the baby, is, the teeth is changing because it's growing, it's coming out, you know what I'm saying? And then it causes some pain, and you know what I'm saying? And they cry, and they, you know, just to be comforted with that teether or whatever, you know what I'm saying? All right, in growth, all right, there is you know, some uncomfortabilities, man. All right, because now, all right, you get stuck in your way, you know what I'm saying? And I'm putting myself saying this, yeah, because here it is, I got to grow in many different facets and ways that I know, all right, I need to work on this or I need to work on that. And then I sit back and chill, and I'll be comfortable, you know what I'm saying? As opposed to, nah, let's go get it, you know what I'm saying? Get out of your comfort zone, go change, work at this. About working, not being stagnant, about being getting better, doing better, growing in the spirit. Huh?
Shock the body.
See?
Hey, I was just talking to the brother Mathati out in Iowa, man. He's like, yeah, you got trip for the rest sometimes. Hey, motherfuckers do bodybuilding. You know, we gotta talk about the brother Murphy. He know all about that. Oh, the brother with the car right there, he works out. They tell you, sometimes I have to plant myself to work out. Sometimes you gotta supplant yourself to get to this word.
Yeah.
Alright? You gotta entice yourself. Sometimes you gotta trip the flesh. The way my doctor broke it down to me was, yeah, you know, I'm sitting here reading shit, my flesh stopped fucking me. I'll watch fucking 10-15 minutes of Big Job. 10-15 minutes of somebody. And then guess what? Now that
I'm woke.
Yeah, yeah. Now I can get back to the scripture. Now the game I was flushing with something like going a little bit. Like a little kid.
Right.
Hey, come on.
Yeah.
I want to see Big Job.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
All right, man. Let me see a little bit. Don't get like two cartoons. All right, now get your ass on.
Right.
Hey, go do your homework.
All right, because you read. Yeah. It's the comforter. So, yeah. You know, you, hey, you wind up kind of getting tired. Your eyes get heavy.
Yeah.
You're like, shit. You're like, okay, well, shit, you want to go to sleep. But, hey, that's a good thing. Like, you know, trick the flesh. Like, y'all, I'm getting, my eyes getting heavy. Get tired, alright, that means the flesh gets weak. You go ahead, what's it say, Big Job?
Alright.
That got me out of it. Sometimes he be having the big boobies on there or something, you know what I'm saying? Like, oh damn, yeah, okay. Alright, cool. Alright, here little nigga. Like you say to your flesh. Now up, you back up.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So go back to Mark. You know what I'm saying? 5 and 9. You know what I'm saying? I'm back up. I didn't trick, you know what I'm saying? The flesh. And then I'm up now. You know, I'm up now. You know, and hey, that's the way it is to grow in the spirit, man. You know, to feed the spirit. That's what it's about. That's it. And you should not fulfill the lust of the flesh, man. And that's the thing. It's a fight, man. Because of course, you know, you're gonna feed the flesh. It's essentials. You know that it needs, of course. But then, even outside of that, you still may feed it a little something that, you know, it within balance, though. You know what I'm saying? You may go watch the Big Job. You may go watch the basketball game. You know what I'm saying? You may go, you know, deal with your little lady or whatever. You know what I'm saying? You may go to the bar and have a drink. You know what I'm saying? You may go to the back cages and, you know, get a few in. Workout or whatever it is that you like to do.
Yep.
Like I always say about the big fat cheeseburger.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? You may have something like that,
yep,
but it's gotta be within balance, man.
Hey, Burke said all the time, he said one bad, he said something about like one bad meal ain't gonna kill you. Alright? Yeah, you eating healthy, you working out like a man. One bad meal ain't gonna fuck you up. You know what I'm saying? Well, that's within balance, man.
Right.
And it's the same thing with this word, man.
And when they say bad, not, you know, not unlawful, but bad as in that way, not so good, greasy, little fried chicken, you know what I'm saying, or the, you know, whatever.
Because you don't want to destroy yourself.
Right. Tacos, pizza, you know what I'm saying. You know, sometimes, hey, man, you go have you some tacos, man. Sometimes you go have you slices and a couple beers or something, you know what I'm saying.
Yeah, be not righteous over much.
Yeah.
Don't be overly righteous, but you can't be overly wicked either, man. So it's got to be balanced. That balance has to be there or you'll destroy yourself.
That's it. And when the
Lord comes, you must have on your wedding garments, man. When the Lord comes, you must be found active in the fight, fighting the flesh, renouncing the flesh, renouncing this world. What you got, brother? Oh, Salaki, you got that, and then you got that.
This Ecclesiastes chapter 10 and verse 16. Woe to thee, O land, when thy king is a child, and thy princes eat in the morning.
Right, man. Woe to them that. Woe to the world when the king was a child, man. See, the brothers just went into it. I was watching the elders, man, the other day, man. They were saying, you got to learn how to be a man before you learn to be a god. Okay? So, hey, man, woe to the world when the king was a child. This motherfucker created some shit called a teenager. Where the fuck is a teenager in the Bible? Alexander the Creek took over the entire known world probably at the age of 14, man. And you niggas is watching Teletubbies, man. So this nigga, what does he do? He dumbs you down and tries to keep you in the state of a child, man. That's why you got all these rappers, little this, baby this. Everybody's a little and everybody's a fucking baby.
And they're being governed by children.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That means don't play with him like that.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Bring him up in under the order.
Yeah.
All right? Discipline. It says, hey, whoop that ass, you know what I'm saying, if he's going wrong. So, hey, when he get older, now he's disciplined. Yeah, exactly.
You can rejoice in him because blessed, happy are we, because the things that are pleasing us to have our shine are made known unto us.
Right.
See, now you get to, when you finally get that, when you get so many afterwards, and then you are here and you understand what's pleasing unto Yahweh, you know how to please him, and you know what pisses him off. And you know how to avoid, I give them strict commandment,
right,
what they should do to avoid punishment.
Right. See, but when the governor, the king, is a child himself, all right,
yeah.
and just, you know, going according to the flesh, willy-nilly, unsatiable, you know, just all flesh, and that's what he's ruling with. That's what he's teaching you. This is what's going on right now in this present evil world, man. All right? But no, it says, hey, put away those childish things, man. Grow up. All right, gird thyself like a man. All right, let's finish that. Then you can get that.
Ecclesiastes 10 and 16, woe to thee, O land, when thy king is a child, and thy princes eat in the morning. Verse 17, blessed art thou, O land, when thy king is the son of the nobles, and thy princes eat in due season, for strength and not for drunkenness.
Blessed is the land when the ruler is the son of nobles. And that's what it says, the Lord shall give it to whom right it is. Alright? So the ones, the true stewards of life, I'm going to be raised up. The scripture says the earnest expectations of the creature waited for the manifestations of the sons of the living power, man.
That's
the whole earth in creation is waiting for Yahweh Shai to take the throne.
That's right. And guess what? Right now is where the aristocrats, those that's going to be the hierarchy, the governing body, the rulers of the eternal righteous kingdom under Yahweh Shai, right now they're being made into kings and priests. They're being made perfect right
hey,
now.
I believe it was the elder Kazak. I believe he said that yesterday, or put it to another brother. He said, kings are not born, kings are made. Yahweh Shai was made.
Yep.
He went through it.
Yep.
Okay? Kings are made, man.
Yeah.
You can't just have a microwave king, man. Nigga just came out of damn incubator, man.
Alright, yep. Uh-huh. Ready to be king.
Yeah. Here I go.
Alright.
Everybody fucked up. A week later,
right.
A week later, everybody's pissed.
See, the king that had to go through this,
that,
to judge righteousness. All right, because he got to judge matters. All right, he got to set standard.
Yeah.
All right, but if you've been through nothing, well, how you gonna do that?
Yeah.
That's it.
Talking about those who have a senses exercise.
That's it. How do you have your senses exercised? By exercising, by experiencing, you know?
By falling seven times?
Yep. That's it.
Yep.
All right? That's what this whole place, this present evil world, is for the perfecting of the saints, man. It's for the perfecting, because it says, you know, how the Lord, he made the world for our sakes. All right? See, but before we get to our inheritance, we had to go through the perfecting process. We had to go through the dangerous place to fall, which was the place that was going to purify and perfect us. That was going to be the place where we get our exercise on. That was going to be the place where we train. Here it is, our people, they want to live their best life in the gym.
I hated that song too when it came out.
Yeah.
Bro, I hated that after that. Happy!
Nah, see, after you hit the gym, you know what I'm saying? That's why I say all winter they working on in the gym. Yeah. So in the summer, they can show off their summer body. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? You know? So here it is, we're in the gym right now. We're being purified and perfected, man. We're being molded. We're being made. All right, we're being sculpted. See, when you, a sculptor ain't just, this wonderful sculptor just pop up just pop. No, the sculptor is made. All right?
Hey, we were just talking about, we just pointed to that mic, we talked about how the suit as a refiner, right, of silver, you know? And we always bring up with that stuff old girl was saying in that video, man, basically about that scripture, about the dude who refines silver, man. She asked him, she said, when do you know it's done? Says, when I can see my reflection in it. All right? And it's the same thing with the truth, man. Yahweh Shai has been formed in us. It's a Hamashiach before you. Somebody grab that. To the Lord be formed in you. Hamashiach be formed in you.
Second Corinthians 4:17. For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal way of glory.
You see, that's the going through the furnace, right? The furnace of affliction. But it says for our life affliction, which is but for a moment. That's this present evil world that was given over unto the hands of the wicked, but for a moment. That's why it says the joy of the hypocrite is but for a moment. Because they only get this world for a moment, right? Because it was for a purpose. And the purpose was for the Israelites to learn. That's why Romans 15:4 says, whatsoever thing is written in time was written for our learning. All right? Because whatever was written was done, or being done, or to be done. And it was all for the learning of the Israelites, so we can rule in the righteous eternal kingdom righteously. And be made, and be righteously, man.
Hey, Bruce Lee got some elected in family.
This Galatians chapter 4 and verse 19. My little children, of whom I am birthed again, like of whom I travail and birthed again until Hamashiach be formed in you.
So Hamashiach be formed in you. See, everybody's being formed into something. You're being molded for an ultimate thing. Because there's a day coming when the Lord said the fruits are ripe. Send the angels to go pluck up some fruits, man. It says the reapers. You know, somebody get that revelation. It says it's time for you to reap. Okay? So when it's ripe, that means it's done. It's formed. Okay? So either you're going to be formed into the image of Yahweh Shai HaMashiach, or you're going to be just formed into some monster, some abomination. Or the Lord's going to look upon, like, what the fuck is this? Right? You know the werewolf transformation and shit?
The nigga get the oh,
right?
And then he's halfway formed and shit, right? So he's a hairy.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Right? And then when he's fully
So you got the grapes of wrath, and you got the grapes of salvation, man. The scripture's talking about it in the second verse. It says, let my grapes be kept, because with great labor have I made it perfect. But you niggas, you that wild grapes. He's like, man, what more could I do to these grapes, man?
And those are the ones that was born in vain.
Yeah.
All right, because they they weren't being, under that molding, yeah. All right, to be made perfect, okay? Because why? They were about this present evil world, being jumped into the furnace of affliction and being molded and being purified and perfected, all right? So you were born in vain, because ultimately, what's going to mold you is that physical fire that the Lord is coming back with, all right? And then and you're not going to be made, you know what I'm saying, like the upper echelon.
And you got niggas crying about some rotten fruit. That's what these niggas are crying about. Man, I'm throwing that away, man. I was finna make some hoops.
Oh.
These niggas in jail and shit, they get their little fruits and shit. They make some hoops and shit, took that shit in the bag, man. That shit getting to make you go blind.
What?
afflicted. And the wine press was throttled out the city, and blood came out of the wine press, even into the horse's bridle, by the space of 1,600 furlongs.
So it's going to be a lot of deadness, a lot of die out.
Matthew chapter 13 and verse 24, another parable put he forth unto them, saying, the kingdom of heaven is likened to a man who sowed good seed in his field, but while men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat.
Right, so you got physical tares, which are the heathens that are sown among Israel, alright? And then you got spiritual tares, which are you two very niggas, man, which are coming out the woodworks now, like a fucking episode of Power Rangers. Those putties, man. Niggas coming out like you like, oh no! Those fucking they call Johnny Cat Cobra himself and shit. Fuck off! Oh, they fighting all the putties and shit. Each time you kill one, two pop up. The niggas got a morph.
It's
going
down,
gotta send the rest of these niggas stuff. You know what I mean?
It's too many
putties.
It's morphing time.
Yeah, right. And you done beat the shit out of 30 of them and shit.
Like 30 more
time. That's these niggas who are the world war. Talking about rap to do.
Yeah,
go ahead.
It says, and went his way, but when the blade was crunked up and brought forth fruit, then appeared the tares also. So the servant of the household came and said unto him, sir, didst thou sow? Didst not thou sow good seed in thy field?
Right, now we're talking about spiritual tares. So, did not thou sow good seed in thy field? Did not thou send, did not you send me the elect? Did not you, talk about that remnant? He said, if they had, if Yahweh had not left us a small remnant, we would be like under Sodom and Gomorrah. And these men had what? The words of life. His word. Did not you put your word into the earth? So what? So who are these niggas? Okay, that ain't fashioned after that. Go ahead.
It says, from whence then have his tares? He said unto them, an enemy have done this. The servant said unto him, will thou think that we go and gather them up? But he said, nay, that's why he gathered up the tares, he root up also the wheat with them.
Right, and it's the same way in this truth, man. You got spiritual tares, man. You got guys that say that they're men of the Lord. They look like men of the Lord.
Yeah.
They talk like men of the Lord. They bring out some of the same breakdown. Okay? But then they'll tell you that the name of the Lord is Jesus. But then they'll tell you that the MOTV is Christianity.
We don't have to wait on the Lord.
Oh yeah, well we don't have to wait on the Lord, man. Alright, go ahead.
It says verse 30, let both grow together unto the harvest.
Right, let both grow together. Let there be an ISUPK, man. Let there be an IUIC. Let there be all these other wayward ass doctrines, man. Let it all grow together, man. Until that time, go ahead.
In the time of harvest, I will say to the reapers, gather ye together first the tares, and bind them in bundles to burn them, but gather the wheat into my barn, and another parable will put forth
right, the same. So the elect are going to be gathered into the barn, man. Alright? They're going to be separated, man. And we're going to see that. The scripture says in that day, then say you know who is my chosen, man. That's the time of JT time. That's when shit get hot. That's when shit's hot. That's when any second, something as small as you going to get a bag of rice can be your last trip out the door, buddy. Alright? That's when shit's going to be real scant out here, man. A bottle of water is going to be life or death, man. Go ahead.
It's Matthew 13 and 36. Then Yahushua sent the multitude away and went into the house, and his disciples came unto him, saying, declare unto us the parable of the tares of the field. He answered and said unto them, he that sowed the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world. The good seed are the children of the kingdom, but the tares are the children of the wicked one.
Right. And you are of your father the devil. Right. And the Lord's visiting you niggas right now. Man. We're in a time where false prophets are being visited. Y'all going to go preach that bullshit and just drop dead, man. Right? Or the Lord just have a pack of wolves just bust through the damn door, man, and just run right up on you, and only you. They just, they go straight for the pastor, right? They ran past
sold them is the devil. Yep. The harvest is the end of the world, and the reapers are the angels.
And I was just talking to the brother Shatari, man. The devil ain't always Esau. The devil is not always Esau, man. You got black ass devils, man.
Insidious. He had that black ass demon in him. That nigga was black as hell playing that fucking.
Hey, what up? Amongst my people are found wicked men.
Yes, sir.
All right, matter of fact, it says that they overpass the deeds of the actual wicked.
Right. Wow.
Yep. So amongst our people, amongst the Israelites, are wicked men, man. All right, and those are the ones that's gonna wind up getting that weeping and gnashing of teeth, man. Those that's of this world. All right, those that are of their fathers, the devil. All right, you made a pact with Satan. Go ahead.
And that's why they're gonna take his mark. Okay, and it ain't that we want you. It's just, hey, that's the prophecy.
Yeah.
All right, that's the boat. See, that's why they hate us so much, man. You see, that's why we're talking about this whole false prophet deal and all this is coming up and all the damn putties are coming out, man. All right? Because at the end of the day, this is the warning. This is the message that Yahweh Shem Yahushua has given his servants to give unto you. You see? Back to that Ezekiel, man. Right? This is the message, man. This is the warning that is being given, man. And that's only, hey, let's be honest, man. There's only a select amount of men worldwide that are truly out in sackcloth, man. You can see it in the spirit of the thing, man. Okay, the other prophets, so-called prophets or men calling upon or whatever they want to call upon and teach whatever they want to teach. Okay, they're not showing that sincerity, man.
And how long is you think the Lord's gonna keep warning you, man, before this shit actually happens?
I remember that robot on a fucking Alaska space. He always say, "Danger, Will Robinson. Danger, Will Robinson.
Warning.
Hey,
warning.
Even that robot, after a while, he don't listen. Fuck you, Will Robinson. Fuck you. I'm going to save myself, Will Robinson.
Remember?
You're a dumbass. Like, after a while, he gonna compute. He's a dumbass.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Fuck him.
Yep, I gotta go. You know what I'm saying? That's it.
That's it, man. But whatever y'all got.
Revelation 14 and 10, it says, "The same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of the Most High, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation, and he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels." Because the brother was just reading the parable of the wheat and the tares, man. Those reapers are the angels, man. Those are the mighty ones that are going to come down with Yahweh Shai, man. And like the brother said, there was like, as if it was two angels, man. One for the reaping and one for the delivering, man. One for the destruction and one for the harvest, man.
All right?
And that's what's going to happen, man. All right? And to me, that's a terrible thought, man. You're going to basically become damn popcorn for the angels, man. You don't imagine being judged, man, in the presence of the holy angels, man. That's a terrible thought, man. All right? But that's the condemnation that is coming for the wicked of Israel and for Esau mainly, man.
All right, because when the prophets saw the visions of the judgment, a lot of them got sick, man. A lot of them fucking, you know what I'm saying, damn, they passed out. Some of them passed out, actually, you know. And it was a whole, and that's men that are way stronger than we are now, man. So, man, if you don't think you need the Lord in these last days, man,
And it also, it goes to show you also what was it when you so used to something, you know, when you've been just programmed or you've been,
brainwashed.
Just hold it to you.
Habitual?
The word escapes me, but like in these days, you know, our people is just accustomed. You know, if that ain't the word, but I was, you know, looking for another one. But we'll just use the custom. We're so, you know, used to and accustomed to these ways right now that, well, you know, we're not literally getting sick like they were. See, back then, they were seeing certain things and literally getting sick. You know what I'm saying? It's just like this. You know, people who been in wars, killed people before, this all and the other thing.
They're hard to see it, they
don't do nothing to them like it would to somebody who's never seen it. They see death or somebody get killed, they throw up. They'll be like, oh shit, he just, you know what I'm saying? But a motherfucker who used to seeing it, you know what I'm saying? They like, oh shit, oh, niggas die every day.
You know what I'm saying?
And they roll with it. So that's what I'm trying to say. Now we're so accustomed to the bullshit of this present world, although we still sighing and crying, we're still mad, you know what I'm saying? But we're not like sick and just throwing up off of, you know, what's going on in this world today, because, hey, we see it all the goddamn time. Back then, it was nothing like it is now. Right? During the time of Ezra, he said, you know, look how much, you know, that Eve produced from the beginning of time up until the time that Ezra was on the scene, and he was like, man, goddamn, it produced a lot. But he said, how much more? All right, ungodliness. And when they saw those visions of the ungodliness of these days, it was like, what the hell is that? Like, what is going on? That's what we gonna, what? I don't even know if that's a man or a woman. And I'm like, what the hell? They were throwing up, man. That's how wicked this place is. That's how upside down it is. God damn! This is crazy, man.
Hey, man. Sometimes you get to the, like, when you watch in certain movies, man, like, you got some villain that's so evil, so monster, so bad, that the hero don't even care if he dies to kill his ass. Like, look, I gotta get to this nigga. Nigga, I don't care if I gotta, nigga, I'm gonna grab this nigga, pull a grenade. Nigga, we gotta, this shit gotta go, man.
Yeah.
Like, look, bro, man, that's the of the elect, man.
Yeah.
That's why they make their bodies to live in sacrifice.
Exactly.
Listen, bro, this nigga got a, oh, Stephen King, I'm talking the first. This dude made a speech, man. He said, I want to kill it. He said, help me. You know, then all his friends gathered around about him. You know what I'm saying? He didn't give a fuck about dying no more, bro. He said, this shit got to die. Either we going to die or he going to die. Okay? And that's the mindset we at with it, man. Okay?
You know, but I call it good.
Yeah, Grad and Habakkuk 3, bro.
Habakkuk 3 and 1. Hey, prayer of Habakkuk, the prophet of Pan Shigonah. Oh Lord, I heard thy speech. Habakkuk 3 and 2, oh Lord, I heard thy speech and was afraid. Oh Lord, revive thy works in the midst of the years. In the midst of the years, make known, and wrath remember mercy.
And wrath remember mercy, man. And that's the prayer we're making, man. Because the scripture says he's going to shake, the earth going to shake to and fro like a drunkard, man. All right? So he's coming to shake terribly the earth, as the scripture says, man. So in the end of the day, look, man, seeing it as though all these things have been dissolved, what manner of persons are we to be, man? We know you coming with that wrath. We know you coming with that destruction, man. Alright? Hey, we coming in the stead of Rahab the harlot, man. We gonna hide the righteous, man. Okay? Hey, we heard the report of you, man. Alright? We know you coming, bro. So guess what we finna do? We finna get ourselves right. Okay? You know? We gonna get ourselves ready for the coming of the Lord, man. So that we may obtain mercy, man. The righteous shall scarcely be saved, man. Alright, so knowing all this, man, you gotta, hey, listen, man, it's time to repent, man. And right now, we're seeing a high level of many antichrists. Get that, man. For all you people that's, all you Christians that's waiting for a nigga to soon die.
Get that door smoke.
Declare antichrist. Bow down to me now.
Yeah,
I'll get it. All y'all antichrist.
Kick it, and I'll give you money.
Okay? You're against my stock power shot, man. And all these things are coming out of the woodwork right now. We're seeing it. I was waiting for that day, too. Now, because we were used to seeing installments here and there, you know, motherfuckers walking up to people and shit. Now they're coming out full force, man. They had a group called full force.
Right.
That's how they, oh, yeah, they're like, fucking, that was them. Go ahead, though.
It's 1 John chapter 2 and verse 18. It says, little children, it is the last time that you have heard that the Antichrist shall come. Even now are there many Antichrists, whereby we know that it is the last time.
That's how you know it's the last time. It's the last time the Antichrist will come out. Alright? But this time, you niggas gonna try to, y'all niggas gonna try to put your hands on the prophet, and you gonna get your ass overcooked, man. Alright? One of the brothers had a dream that some niggas tried to come out of the ship, and he shot a laser beam out of his mouth and took out a whole ship. All right? This time you touch the prophet. Oh, let's talk about that. This man who said they'd be killed, man. Oh, said fire should come out their mouth, man. All right, you fuck with the prophet this time, it's gonna be some shit. If I be a man of the Lord, let fire come down with that.
Revelation chapter 11 and verse 5. If any man will hurt them, fire proceedeth out of their mouth. It's Revelation chapter 2 and verse 11. Revelation 11 and verse 3. And I will give power unto my two witnesses, and they shall prophesy 1,260 days. Clothed in sackcloth.
Clothed in spectacular garments.
Sackcloth.
Clothed in the best silk that's purple that IUIC can buy.
Sackcloth.
So they're not going to be having shiny garments. They're going to look like bums.
Sackcloth.
Sackcloth is something that bums wear, isn't it?
Bumalikes.
Bumalikes.
Okay.
So the real prophets would be bums.
Bumkin.
Yeah. All right, I'll wear that. We wear that with pride.
Go ahead.
Righteous pride.
These are the two olive trees and the two candlesticks standing before the Most High of the earth, before the power of the earth. And if any man will hurt them, fire proceedeth out of their mouth and devoureth their enemies. And if any man will hurt them, he must in this manner be killed.
Yeah, this time, it's right there. This shall not be the same. To die and then take off the crown. This shall not be the same. This ain't gonna be when you kill the prophets of the past, man. You niggas was able to just gather together a bunch of black and white. I bet they had black and miles back then. Y'all niggas had black and miles and happy campus back then. They just ain't had, they ain't recovered the bucks yet. They got niggas who be spitting on them. They run a little bit. You bitch ass niggas, man. You gonna try to kill the prophet this time, the Lord gonna come see about your ass. What happened to Heliodorus, man? You know, everybody get that account. But his ass came and tried to raid the temple, man. Alright? And the Lord sent angels to come beat his ass, man. Alright? This time we're the temple. So how much, so what do you think is gonna happen when you try to come at us, man? It's gonna do some new shit on your ass, man. You niggas think you're gonna pull up, man. With a Draco. The Lord will have a man of war fucking zap your ass with laser beams out of his eyes, man. And catch a bullet with his teeth, man. Alright? And we believe this, man. You think, y'all didn't think it was crazy when them niggas were saying they was gonna get powers, man. Was that last year? The niggas were talking about they was gonna get powers. They did that skit.
Yeah, that was like early last week.
Y'all niggas ain't no powers, man. The Lord ain't giving a nigga no powers, man. He giving the real Israelites powers, man. And that's during the time of Jacob's trouble. It's gonna be as needed. Alright? If you get a nigga power right now, hit me in the bank right now with a bunch of hoes, fucking smoking a black man.
Right. Should have never gave you niggas money.
Can't give a nigga no damn money. The Lord ain't finna give you niggas rich and not comely for a nigga, man. You'll be a super GD, man. You'll be a super fucking GD, man. Devo comes fly five the sky. You gotta tuck your chain. He can see through your shirt. I know you got a chain on, nigga.
Hey, you'll be the, like the dude say, you know, on the social media, they doing a 10-year challenge. I know y'all seen it. One nigga you got in that shit and said, hey, I learned a lot, I've been through a lot of things, but I'm still the same nigga.
Yeah. Gotcha.
crowd. Wait, what? How you learn? You still the same nigga.
Hey, old girl, Rita. What's that bitch, Rita? Make my nigga grow.
Make my nigga grow.
That nigga just became a bigger nigga, man. You know what I'm saying? Right, he started out as a little nigga. You got a Power Rangers. You gotta talk about Power Rangers.
Yeah.
Then they see the roar. Now he's a big ass nigga.
Oh shit.
Yeah, you became a bigger nigga, man. Oh, like a Pokemon, you evolved that nigga. That nigga evolved to a greater nigga.
Right.
This worst nigga.
See, that's what the importance of going through the straight gate, man, to be molded. All right, that's the importance of killing the old man. All right, and being born again, all right? Born again in the spirit and growing in the spirit, man. Because no matter how we was growing in carnality and going according to our own minds or the ways of the mind of man, period, shit, you grow up to be just a bigger nigga. And you the same nigga, just bigger.
Evolved.
Right.
Hey, that's what Esau did. He went from being a serpent to a dragon.
Right, exactly.
Dragon's nigga. First he was just a little fucking... You probably didn't even notice his ass. See,
that's a big ass dragon.
Right.
It's totally evolved, man.
Exactly.
That's you niggas, man.
Yeah, but that's the thing, man. You know, motherfuckers, it's the same old niggas. In this present evil world, you know what I'm saying? No matter if, you know, at this point, you had, $1,000 in your account, and at this point now you got $1 billion literally in your account, but you the same nigga. You know what I'm saying? Motherfuckers think that that's broke, think that that's bullshit. Nah, you the same nigga, man. All right, still in vain, because you ultimately headed to death.
It is broke though. It's completely broke. It's like having a fucking
a tumor.
Yeah, like
a tumor.
An improv. What you call an improvement, nigga? My chest big.
Nigga.
It's a big ass tumor, though, man. Like, what's up, smoke? I don't even got to get out of the gym, like, you. My chest big.
Nigga,
you got a malignant tumor, nigga. Like, you're going to die.
Right, right.
What's up with you, bro?
Right.
Nigga bragging on the tumor.
Right, exactly.
That's you, motherfucker, man.
That's what it is, man. out here in this world, man. Nah, we got to kill the old man. All right, we gotta renounce corruption. We gotta renounce this present evil world. This is not our rest. All right, this is the place where, hey, you know what? Now we didn't, hey, it says, hey, let that be sufficient, man. You did all that niggerdom, all right? You had to experience it, to touch it. Let that be sufficient.
Let that be enough.
All right, and now grow in the spirit. Be purified and perfected. Roll with the spirit. Roll with the power, because that's wise. Fear the Lord, right, to know that there's a consequence of nigger. You know what I'm saying? You got something?
You said that's wise. Ecclesiastes 7:4 says the heart of the wise is in the house of mourning.
You see, the heart of the wise is in the house of mourning, because right now, all right, we're in the place where the earth is given over into the hand of the wicked. All right? We're in the place where the wicked gets to enact this wickedness and put out vibrations. So in that world, we gotta mourn, not be all fun and accomplice and, you know, wicked. No, you know, this is the place where we're mourning, yet we're growing in the spirit and learning. All right, go ahead.
It says, but the heart of the fool, but the heart of fools is in the house of mirth.
You see, the house of fools is in the heart of fools is in the house of mirth, man. You having fun right now. Alright, in a wicked world that's slated for destruction, man. This ain't where I want to live my best life and have fun. So the fun could be abruptly ended.
Right.
Alright? And then ultimately, you know, shit. It says what moth and rust don't corrupt. Thieves can break through and steal. You can go outside, smell something wrong, and be a vegetable yourself at the end of the day.
Hey, or those gangster movies you see at the end. Like the nigga smoking a cigarette and playing, I did it my way. This nigga's like, alright, this nigga keep the driving into the fucking enemies. That's how I ended for his ass, right?
Well, at least
Same takes to you, I can push in this word with truth.